front, how's the transition from offense to back to the defensive line?
Well, coming in, it was very challenging because, you know, it wasn't really what I wanted to do. I saw an opportunity to help the team, so that's what I did ultimately. I just put my pride aside and went over there and did what I had to do to help the team. I really didn't understand it in the beginning because I was like, you know, why do I have to go to offense and this and that? But going over there actually helped me become a better defensive player because I understand blocking schemes. Before, I didn't quite understand gap control and stuff like that, like the details, but being put in that uncomfortable situation really made me grow up and mature, and I think it's made me 10 times better as a defensive player. So.
How comfortable are you being back at defensive tackle?
I'm very comfortable. It's what I've been playing all my life. When I went over to offense, that was actually the first time I played offense since I was in seventh grade. So it was a little bit different, but I mean, just that with anything, I just learned that, you know, probably my most uncomfortable situations have produced the most growth for me. So, you know, overall, I just really appreciated that opportunity. Now on defense, I'm appreciating this opportunity because I get to do what I love to do. So.
Is that the plan all along, to have you move back to defensive tackle after this year, or after last year?
Excuse me?
Was that the plan all along, to have you move back to defense after last year?
It really wasn't. It was since I'm a senior, type of guy Coach Sweeney is. You know, he just gave me the opportunity to play what it is that I wanted to play. In the beginning, you know, I talked to Jeff Scott and Coach Elliott, and they asked me if I wanted to play like a Darryl Smith type role, where I would just be that lead guy. You know, so that was a possibility, but it came down to it. I just missed defense, and you know, like I said, the type of guy Coach Sweeney is, he allowed me to do whatever I wanted.
Has the departure of DJ Reader really motivated you now that the opportunity's there to get a lot more playing time?
Well, I feel like I've been motivated a long time because I've been here, I joke around and say I've been here half a decade. So, you know, when you put it in that perspective, I mean, I've been here a long time. So, you know, it's just been a lot of work being put in. You know, departure of DJ, you know, it's unfortunate, but it's next man up here. So, you know. Myself and the other guys, we're just going to step it up a little bit, you know, just that much more that we have to give, you know, to just be our best and complete the team goals.
You know, a lot of press has been given to the younger guys, the freshmen, the red shirts that have come in and kind of made some noise on the depth chart, especially from folks in the media. As an older guy, did you take that kind of personally, knowing that you were here and it was kind of your turn to have a role in that 2D?
You know, I really don't worry about stuff like that. I'm a guy that feels like, you know, what's for me is for me. I have favor over my life, so I really don't worry about stuff like that. And I think that's the great thing about this team is that not only myself, but Carlos and Scott and DJ, we made it a top priority to make sure that those guys would be ready. So, I put Christian in a lot of uncomfortable situations over the summer. It's like we would be doing drills, and I would just give him a play signal, you know, just throw it out of nowhere. He responded well, and I think that's the biggest thing. I'm really proud of those freshmen, the way they came in and worked the summer, and the way that they responded. I'm a guy that's, you know, I really don't care about the attention or anything. I feel like as long as I do my work and do my part, everything will play itself out. And I just really wanted to make sure that Christian was ready, the other freshmen were ready, because I want to win. But I'm not worried about them taking playing time from me or anything like that. I just want to win. So I want him to be in the, him and as well as the other freshmen, be in the best position to excel. So.
Is that something that you kind of comes with a package with you, or is that something you had to learn over time to get to that point where you kind of teaching and leading them?
That's just the type of guy I am. I really want those guys to be successful. Even though, you know, it's a competition, you know, I gotta try to beat them to play. But at the end of the day, I just really want those guys to be successful. And I look at it like a Jabril Robinson, and I see myself a lot because, you know, as a guy who's very talented, but just may not have it all together yet. And with how things are playing out in this situation, you know, you can get discouraged. Like Sterling Johnson, another freshman, and game. You know, they're redshirting, so, you know, they could be discouraged. And I look at those guys, and I'm able to help them because I didn't quite have that, you know, pick me up at that time. So I see them, and I just see myself a few years ago. So I'm able to, you know, tell them, you know, it's a process. Everything's going to be okay. You know, you're good. Don't think that you're not good because you're redshirting. It's an opportunity to get better. So I really embraced that role to where I'm able to help them, the younger guys, and I made it a priority that I just put them in a position to be successful.
This is a detail-oriented defense. Just how big is the gap between what you know and what the freshmen
do? To be honest, I pour everything that I know into them. You know, even though it took me 5 years to get it, and it's only taking them a couple months, that doesn't matter. I just want to make sure that they have everything they need to succeed so that we can be a top defense. So, you know, I mean, I might have played a little bit, a few more snaps, but, you know, as far as details and, you know, really understanding their job and why they're doing it, we, all the upperclassmen made sure that those guys, like,